My File Explorer has that nice feature to select some files using a pattern. For example, that pattern will match only files ending with .jpg. This kind of pattern is called the Glob pattern and is available from the command line too. In fact, it comes from the command line world. But maybe you already know that. Anyway, stay with me. Glob patterns may be more subtle than you imagine. The star we've seen in the introduction is by far the most commonly found pattern. A star in a glob pattern will match any sequence of characters in a file name, including the empty sequence. For example, that pattern will match all file names starting with the word report, followed by a dot, followed by anything. And it will even match the file name report.nothing. By the way, the star may appear anywhere in a glob pattern. And you can even have several stars in the same pattern. I let you a few seconds to guess which files will match that pattern. Okay, you guessed it? That pattern will match any file name containing the sequence of letters PORT, including at the start or at the end of the file name. Before digging into all the forms of glob patterns, we have to clarify a few little things concerning the matching process. First, you have to understand it's the shell that will replace the glob pattern by the list of matching files. This is an important feature allowing you to use the glob pattern with any command. Second, for the shell to understand a word as a glob pattern, you must not quote the special characters of the pattern. Here and here, the shell will not perform pathname expansion. But it will perform pathname expansion here and here. Next, there is one case where the shell do not perform expansion of unquoted glob patterns. This is when there is no matching file. One might expect that command to display nothing as there is no matching file name. But in that case, the shell will transmit the pattern verbatim to the underlying command, which is, most of the time, totally unable to handle that. In fact, there is very, very few standard commands that can process glob patterns, as most of them simply rely on the shell for taking care of that. Last but not least, you may know by convention, a file whose name is starting with a dot is considered as hidden on Unix-like systems. The shell follows that convention, and by default, it will not consider any hidden file as a candidate when matching a glob pattern. So the shell will not try to match hidden files in that case. But it will if the glob pattern is starting explicitly with a dot. So if you want both hidden and non-hidden files, you must choose two patterns. Okay, now you have a better understanding of the pattern matching process. So it's time to examine the few other patterns beyond the star. Whereas a star will match a sequence of characters of any length, the question mark is used instead to match only one character. It can be any character, but it will be only one character. For example, I could write that to match any open document file. As of myself, I find the question mark most useful when I need to match files of a given length. For example, that pattern will match files whose name is made of exactly 8 characters. The star matches anything. The question mark matches any character. But we can be even more restrictive with the last glob pattern, the character set. This one will match one and only one character, like the question mark. But in addition, you will specify the set of possible matching characters. For example, did you remember the pattern we used to match any open document file? We could refine it to match only text or drawing documents. Character enumeration is nice, but for a sequence of consecutive characters, you may use a character range instead. Like this one. Or that one. And by using a caret right after the opening bracket, you can even specify the complementary set of the matching characters. In that case, the pattern will match any character except those you've specified. As a little challenge now to test your understanding, what will this match? By the way, you know on most Unix file systems, file names are case sensitive, don't you? So, surprise! As you can see in my shell, the filename blueberry.jpg with a lowercase b has matched the range. However, when using an explicit character set instead of a range, it works as expected. This is an obscure feature of the bash, which may or may not include characters of the other case in a range, depending on your locale settings. In computing, a locale is a set of parameters to handle country-specific settings, such as the symbol used as a decimal separator or the default sort order. Here are the current locale settings on my system. We won't dig too much into that topic. For today, all you have to know is the lcall environment variable will override all other locale settings. And a special local called C is used to force the system to use the traditional POSIX settings instead of any country-specific settings. Most notably, the C local will distinguish between lowercase and uppercase letters in a range. In other words, if you want to ensure the traditional interpretation of a range, you will have to set the lcall environment variable to the special value C. So, did I lie when I said you may discover new things by watching this video? If you like my teaching style, why not taking my Bash and Linux command line course on Udemy? And don't forget to check my website for a great discount coupon.